Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a failing ECU. So to clear up some confusion off the bat, the term ECU can often be confusing and thrown around in a lot of different ways in the automotive world. So ECU actually stands for Electronic Control Unit, or it may also be referred to as an ECM, meaning Electronic Control Module. And modern cars can have dozens, even 100 plus different ECUs. Essentially, an ECU is an electronic control unit that is responsible for controlling a specific or set of electrical systems or subsystems within a vehicle. Our main focus here is on the engine control unit. And with that, the ECU or the engine control unit does have a few different names that are frequently used. There's ECM for engine control module, and some other common terms include the DME or digital motor electronics, or PCM, which stands for powertrain control modules. And PCMs, particularly when you have a powertrain control module, that generally refers to an electronic control unit that controls both the engine and the transmission. So focusing on the ECU or ECM in particular, the engine control unit in particular is responsible for controlling a number of very important and critical operations of the vehicle's engine. The ECU is responsible for controlling fuel injection, the ignition system, ignition timing, any sort of variable valve timing or variable valve list systems, as well as the cooling system, launch control, etc. So virtually anything related to engine operation is going to be controlled by the computer known as the engine control unit or the engine control module. Now, the way that the ECU is able to control the engine and handle things like fuel injection, the ignition system, ignition timing, etc., is by using signals from various sensors throughout the engine. So some of the most important sensors that the ECU or ECM does utilize include the acceleration pedal position sensor, the throttle position sensor, crankshaft and camshaft position sensors, oxygen sensors, NOx sensors, a coolant temperature sensor. Really, the list goes on and on. There are dozens and dozens of different sensors on modern engines and vehicles that are all used by the ECU to determine proper operation and calibration of the engine and all of its parameters. Ultimately, because the ECU relies on signals from so many different sensors and is responsible for so many critical components of proper engine operation, when you do run into ECU or ECM failure, the symptoms can be rather lengthy and vary significantly depending on the ECU failure that you run into specifically. It really boils down to what part of the ECU fails internally that determines what kind of symptoms you may experience on your specific vehicle, and not only what specifically fails internally, but how it fails. It may just be shorting out and kind of intermittently getting or sending the right signals, and other times it's shorting out and just not getting the right information or sending out the right information. So again, a lot of different symptoms, a lot of different things that you may notice with ECU failure. So with that, let's go ahead and jump in and look at a longer list of symptoms associated with a faulty or failing ECM. Some of those common symptoms include a check engine light, the engine failing to crank or actually turn over, the engine stalling, misfires, rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, surging, power loss, poor performance, poor fuel economy, and really just an overall poor operation of the engine are all common symptoms with an ECU fault or failure. And one other symptom to throw in here as well is OBD2 fault codes. Now, these fault codes can be helpful in detecting an ECU failure, but it's also not always the easiest to tell because generally these codes will include things like engine misfires. It may relate to specific sensors within the engine. You might start getting codes for oxygen sensors or the camshaft or crankshaft position sensors. Really what it boils down to when it comes to OBD2 codes that indicate that you do have an ECM failure, typically you'll all of a sudden get a long list of these fault codes. That isn't always the case, but that is generally seen with a lot of ECM or engine control unit failures, is that you do get a lengthy list of those problems just because, again, it relies on so many of those different sensors. And if the ECM starts failing, it might be detecting or thinking indicating that a number of those sensors are bad, which are then leading to misfires and other issues, which will also get triggered as diagnostic trouble codes or fault codes. So it can be a rather lengthy list of those OBD2 codes when you do run into engine control module failure. Basically, almost any kind of symptom or issue you can experience with an engine, a faulty ECM can cause similar symptoms and varying degrees of the severity of the symptoms. And that really just boils down to how the ECM fails and how serious the failure is when it does occur. Moving on to diagnosing a faulty and failing ECM. This is honestly a really challenging thing to diagnose. And a lot of the times it really just boils down to trial and error and the process of elimination. Again, with the symptoms that you have here, they can be a lot of similar symptoms to much simpler problems on an engine, such as spark plugs, ignition coils, fuel injectors, a faulty camshaft position sensor, faulty oxygen sensors. When you look at common problems on most engines, an ECU or an ECM is going to be very low down on the list. If you consider what possibly went wrong or failed, you're probably going to start looking at things like spark plugs, fuel injectors, ignition coils right off the bat. You're going to start looking at sensors, and the ECU is really going to be at the bottom of the list because these really don't tend to fail or run into issues all that often on most vehicles. Usually the engine control modules are very reliable, especially for the first 15 or 20 years of a car's life. It's a pretty rare problem. And so that's why a lot of the times this can be challenging to diagnose. And so usually when it comes to diagnosing a failing engine control module, a lot of the times it does come down to that process of elimination. Unless you have certain things that are really pointing you to the ECM, it's really best to start with the basics first, make sure the spark plugs are good, the ignition coils are good, you don't have a fuel injector issue or a sensor causing the issue. And then after that, it's time to move on to the engine control module. So with that said, if you do suspect you have an issue with the ECU, again, it can be challenging. It does require some experience with working on cars and engines, simply because it does usually require that process of elimination, starting with all of the basics and then working your way down to the ECM, which if nothing else fixes a problem, then chances are it very well may be the engine control module that is responsible for all of the issues and symptoms that you're running into. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.